Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
La pandemia ha messo in risalto quanto siamo tutti vulnerabili e interconnessi. Se non ci prendiamo cura l'uno dell'altro, a partire dagli ultimi, da coloro che
sono maggiormente colpiti, the pandemic continues to cause deep wounds, exposing our vulnerability.
Non possiamo guarire il mondo. E da lodare l'impegno di tante persone che in questi mesi stanno dando prova dell'amore umano e cristiano verso il prossimo, dedicandosi ai malati anche a rischio della propria salute. Ma sono degli eroi, eh? Tuttavia, il coronavirus non è l'unica malattia da combattere. Ma la pandemia ha portato alla luce patologie sociali più ampie. Una di queste è la visione distorta della persona, uno sguardo che ignora la sua dignità e il suo carattere relazionale. A volte guardiamo gli altri come oggetti, oggetti da usare e scartare. In realtà, questo tipo di sguardo accecca e fomenta una cultura dello scarto.
The pandemic has highlighted how vulnerable and interconnected everyone is. If we do not take care of one another, starting with the least, with those who are most impacted, including creation, we cannot heal the world. Commendable is the effort of so many people who have been offering evidence of human and Christian love for neighbor, dedicating themselves to the sick, even at the risk of their own health. However, the coronavirus is not the only disease to be fought, but rather, the pandemic has shed light on broader social ills. One of these is a distorted view of the person, a perspective that ignores the dignity and relationship of the person. At times, we look at others as objects to be used and discarded. In reality, this type of perspective blinds and fosters an individualistic and aggressive throwaway culture, which transforms the human being into a consumer good. In the light of faith, we know instead that God looks at a man and a woman in another manner. He created us not as objects, but as people, loved and capable of loving, in His image and likeness. In this way, He has given us a unique dignity, calling us to live in communion with Him, with our brothers and sisters, with respect for all creation. We can't think of living with creation without this sense of harmony. That's a distortion. And in this communion, God gives us the ability to procreate and safeguard life, to till and keep the land. We have an example of that individualistic perspective in the Gospels, in the request made to Jesus by the mother of the disciples, James and John. She wanted her sons to sit at the right and the left of the new king. But Jesus proposes another type of vision, that of service and of giving one's life for others. And he confirms it by immediately restoring sight to two blind men and making them his disciples. Seeking to get ahead in life, to be superior to others, destroys harmony. This is the logic of dominion, to dominate others. Harmony is something else, it's service. Therefore, let us ask the Lord to give us eyes, attentive eyes to our brothers and sisters, especially those who are suffering. As Jesus' disciples, we do not want to be indifferent or individualistic. These are two awful types of behavior. I look at you, but instead I look the other way. Individualism, I'm only looking for my own interests. Harmony created by God asks us to look at the others, at the others' needs, others' problems, to be in communion. We want to recognize, we want to recognize the human dignity in every person, whatever his or her race, language, or condition might be. Human dignity which is created by God, puts man at the center, and that's what we are seeking. The Second Vatican Council emphasized that this dignity is inalienable because it was created to the image of God. It lies at the foundation of all social life and determines its operative principles. In modern culture, the closest reference to the principle of the inalienable dignity of the person is the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which St. John Paul II defined as a milestone on the long and difficult path of the human race, and as one of the highest expressions of the human conscience. Rights are not only individual, but also social. Rights of peoples and nations. The human being, in fact, in his or her personal dignity, is a social being created in the image of God, one and triune. We are social. We need to be able to live in this social harmony. But when there is egoism, our vision doesn't go out toward others, but it turns in on ourselves. And this makes us, it makes us bad. It destroys this harmony. This renewed awareness of the dignity of every human person has serious social, economic, and political implications. Looking at our brother and sister and the whole of creation as a gift received from the love of the Father inspires attentive behavior, care, and wonder. In this way, the believer, contemplating his or her neighbor as a brother or sister and not as a stranger, looks at him or her compassionately and empathetically, not contemptuously or with hostility. Contemplating the world in the light of faith, with the help of grace, we strive to develop our creativity and enthusiasm in order to resolve the ordeals of the past. We understand and develop our abilities as responsibilities that arise from this faith, as gifts from God to be placed at the service of humanity and of creation. While all of us are working for a cure for a virus that strikes everyone without distinction, faith exhorts us to commit ourselves seriously and actively to combat indifference in the face of violations of human dignity. This culture of indifference that is accompanied by this culture, throwaway culture, only those things that don't touch me, they don't interest me. Faith always requires that we let ourselves be healed and converted from our individualism, whether personal or collective. May the Lord restore our sight so as to discover what it means to be members of the human family. And may this sight be translated into concrete actions of compassion and respect for every person and of care and safeguarding of our common home. Thank you.